Christmas, the story that everybody is experiencing, an intense blast of searing heat that has pushed parts of Victoria to their hottest spring day on record.
As the mercury soared, emergency services were kept busy answering calls for heat-related illnesses.
Well, Melbourne's day began mildly enough, 19 degrees at 6 a.m. By midday, it had reached 34 and climbing. The maximum of 39 came just after 3 p.m. And much of tonight won't be very pleasant. TEN's Nicole Strawn begins our coverage.
As Melbourne sweltered, the city's infrastructure struggled to cope. An electrical transformer exploding, the charred ruins hitting a van waiting at traffic lights.
There was two occupants, both were very lucky not to be injured. There was quite a big blast, sort of a part of the blast hit the front windscreen.
Construction workers downed tools once it hit 35 degrees as heat distress became a risk.
Go home and jump in the pool.
It was one way to keep cool, but not everyone was so lucky. Across the day, paramedics received calls for help with people suffering dehydration and heat exposure. The searing heat also put pressure on power supplies. 4,300 homes and businesses were blacked out. More than 100 are still without power. The demand likely to remain high throughout the night.
The temperatures up until about around midnight will be reasonably warm, still up near 30 degrees.
Firefighters were on alert all day, but there were no major outbreaks.
We've certainly put a lot of aircraft on standby in the west, the northwest and the Melbourne Basin today that we wouldn't have ordinarily had today.
Spare a thought, though, for residents in the state's north. The mercury soared even higher, Mildura reaching 44.7, its hottest November day on record. It forced farmers to abandon harvesting.
It's getting too hot for the machines and, you know, fire risk is too risky.
While this hot spell won't last long, the CFA says it should serve as a timely reminder for people that they need to prepare for the bushfire season ahead.
Coming off the back of a reasonably wet summer last year and then a wet winter, the growth, particularly in the grassland, has been abundant, so people need to be aware of the extra fuel that's around their properties.
But the Firefighters Union has warned Victoria is still under-resourced, especially when it comes to fighting fires from the air.
For 2 years we've been lucky. We've had very wet summers. It's damn critical.
Elvis, the Ericsson Sky Crane, will arrive next week after being delayed by a waterfront union dispute in the US. Nicole Strawn.